Another video right now, so I'm going to do another video, and starting in Mark 10, I have no idea what's in here, so thank you, Lord. And he, Jesus, arose from thence and cometh into the coast of Judea by the farther side of Jordan, and the people resort unto him again. And as he was wont, he taught them again. And the Pharisees came to him and asked him. The Pharisees were the Jewish people under law. Now, don't hate Jews. Okay, stop hating Jews. Whoever you are out there, stop hating Jews. I don't even know why people hate Jews, okay? I have no idea. It's just strange to me. So when we read about the Pharisees, these were Jewish people under their own religious laws, and Jesus came. He is the Messiah. He is Jewish also, okay? But the Pharisees, now that could mean even in Christianity, you can apply that to Christianity, the Pharisees that are Christian Pharisees, okay? Or whosoever is a Pharisee. You could look at me and think that I'm a Pharisee, okay? And so it's okay. I forgive you, but I'm not a Pharisee, I don't think. But I could be in some ways. We could all be Pharisees in some ways. So let's just get this straight right now. We really can be all, we can all be at one time or another, or in different areas of our lives, we can be Pharisees, just like the Pharisees of the Bible who, you know, and the Pharisees came, verse 2 here, and the Pharisees came to him and asked him, is it lawful for a man to put away his wife, tempting him? Now, I'm not a biblical scholar, so I'll let the experts, you Google this and you do a study on your own, okay? Because I'm just reading the Bible here. I'm just reading the Word, and if there's anything I might say about it, it may be from God, it may be from me. I'm not attributing everything I say on these videos to God Almighty, okay? I'm overcoming some things of my own personal things. Just getting on a video and doing a video and getting over myself is something I deal with, and I'm finally able to finally do that. I think I'm doing that. I might go to another level one day and be able to speak to people out in a group, but I'm not wishing for that. I'm not even praying for that. I mean, I'm like, no, I don't think so. Thank you anyway. Not because I'm afraid, just because I don't want to deal with it. Okay. So, and the Pharisees came to him. Now let's just read again, okay? And he arose from thence and cometh into the coast of Judea by the farther side of Jordan. You got to remember why they crucified Jesus, and you got to keep in mind that he was crucified for our sins. He was meant to go to the cross and be the sacrifice. So, you know, keep all that in mind when you're reading the Bible about Jesus, especially. And the people resort unto him again, and as he was wont, he taught them there. Now, they had a problem with him attracting crowds, okay? So they didn't want, anyway. And the Pharisees came to him and asked him, is it lawful for a man to put away his wife, tempting him? They were always tempting him and questioning him. And he answered and said unto them, what did Moses command you? And they said, Moses suffered to write a bill of divorcement and to put her away. And Jesus answered and said unto them, for the hardness of your heart he wrote you this precept. But from the beginning of the creation God made them male and female. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife. You know, in my opinion, a man has to first leave his mother and father. He has to let go of his parents in order to, you know, and cleave to his wife, okay? You know, this is talking about marriage here, okay? And they twain shall be one. So then they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. So we want to be careful about, we want to pray for marriages. We don't want to be the person that would split up a marriage. Okay, because whatsoever God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. Now, there are times, and this is my opinion, there are times that we make mistakes in life. I'm not saying we make mistakes. I'm saying God's grace, and over here, what he's talking about. So I'll let the experts on this subject explain it to you. So you go research it on your own, Google it, and find out from the expert pastors and teachers. And if it's not out there, then maybe they're just not getting their materials out there. But maybe your church or your pastor will explain this to you, okay? Maybe your pastor will explain this to you, okay? Because I'm not an expert on this. I'm just throwing in my 2 cents worth. And sometimes it is God. Sometimes maybe it is God speaking through me, okay? And this is surely God's word right here. Okay, this is not me, this is God. Okay, and they twain shall be one flesh, so then they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. And in the house his disciples ask him again of the same matter. And he saith unto them, Whosoever shall put away his wife and marry another committeth adultery against her. Against his wife. Okay. And he saith unto them, Whosoever shall put away his wife and marry another committeth adultery against her. And if a woman shall put away her husband and be married to another, she committeth adultery. And they brought young children to him. That's a complicated subject, you know. Because I could go into depths about that, but I'm just reading the word here because I don't want to explain something to you that's not right that I don't know about, okay? All I know is that God's grace is sufficient and He forgives us. If we've been through a divorce, He has forgiven us. Yes, He has. So don't let anybody in the church condemn you and put a guilt trip on you. Because maybe they've never been through a difficult marriage where things happened, and maybe you made a mistake and married the wrong person. I mean, life is complicated, okay? There's no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, right? So how dare anybody condemn you if something happened in your marriage, or maybe you married the wrong person, or maybe it just you just You know, hell happens, okay? And you know, so it didn't work. It's complicated. But we pray for marriages. We pray that the devil will stay out. We bind the devil from marriages. You know, if we don't know anything at all, if we don't know what we're talking about on here, you know what we can do? We can take what we read here and we could pray for marriages and bind the devil out of marriages because it's rough at times. Can you imagine? Two people getting together and two different people with their own set circumstances and trying to make it work and have the devil come and try to split your marriage up. Okay? So let's pray for marriages instead of condemning the divorced people, because I don't know what the law is on this, okay? But Jesus came to set us free from the law of sin and death, okay? He's good, okay? And they brought a young, and so they went right back into this scripture in 13, and they brought young children to him. And children, you know, are get the brunt of maybe a bad marriage or a divorce. So God help the children of divorced people. God help the children in a bad marriage. Protect them from the adults that might be acting like having a bad time. And it affects the children, okay? Let's stop hating. Let's stop hating and judging, okay? Unless you've walked in somebody's shoes in that area of life, maybe you just need to pray for those kind of people, okay? Those people that have been through more hell than you have in your life, and maybe your marriage made it. Well, praise God, it made it. Wonderful. We're happy for you. We're so happy for you, but think of all the marriages that didn't make it. You know, so stop being acting like you're better than thouest. You know, I know a lot of people in in church, they have great marriages. And you know, who knows what's going on behind closed doors though? You know what I'm saying? Who knows what's going on behind closed doors in those marriages that they look all nice and shiny and happy and everything. And 'cause you know, we go to church and we put on our church smile. Hi, how are you? Oh, I'm doing good, Sister So and So. How about you? Oh, I'm doing great too. Blessed. How you doing? Blessed. Oh, I'm happy. You don't have any problems. Blessed. Oh, okay. You know what I'm saying? Let's be real, okay? Okay. And they brought young children to him that he should touch them, and his disciples rebuked those that brought them. What? And when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and saith unto them, Suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. And you know what? I know it's talking about children here, but there's adults that are still have the childlike child in them, and they get rebuked, you know, because the Pharisees in a church look down on them because they have a few problems. Shh, let's don't talk about our problems in church. Let's don't be real. Let's just go watch the sermon. And okay, I know, I'm not coming against church and sermons, okay? You get it? You get it. You get what I'm saying here. Okay, but let's be real. We go to church and we spend an hour in, and I'm not downing on church right now. I'm just saying you can get so high on that mountain and then you go back to real life. I'd rather stay in real life because I can't handle that up and down and that roller coaster ride. I'm sorry. Okay, and then we try to pretend like we're like the world. If we just get an espresso machine, we can get more people here, more millennials. I'm not condemning you for getting a mach you know, a coffee machine, a you know, espresso machine. I'm not condemning you for that. I'm just saying people are looking for real. And if you want more real, if you want more people in your church, you shouldn't want more people in your church because you want more people in your church. What, to make an idol out of you and your church? You should want people to come to your church because you want to be real with them, and they're looking for real. They're tired of this thing called quote unquote church and religion, and no one, when they get there, it's just going to be empty promises because of the fakers, okay? Oh yeah, I'm going deep. Okay. I knew I would be doing this one day. Going deep. I have no idea what I'm saying here. But maybe God really is speaking through me, the nut on TV, on YouTube. Call me a nut if you want to. I don't care. Let's laugh together. Let's laugh at me together, okay? But let's get real, 'cause God wants real. He's not going to be able to help more people on this earth until the church gets real. Okay, I mean, you know, that's just coming out of me. You know, we play this religious church game, okay? Let's all get dressed up and just look our best. The Sunday best. I'm sorry. I never was comfortable doing that. I hope someday that I am, 'cause I got me some heels. I got about 10 pair of heels, high heels. I'm going to have two elders walk me up to the podium if I ever get to talking to a church. I'm joking, okay? Don't worry. I'm not trying to come to your church, okay? But I have my high heels ready, and I need to start practicing in them because I'm going to wear those beautiful high heels one day, okay? And I'm going to walk in them. But like I say, I might have to have two brothers holding my arms to get me up there. And up there to that podium to preach to y'all. Don't get scared. Don't worry. I'm not going there. I'm not trying to go there. Okay. I'm just joking with you. Okay. And when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. Now let's get back to little children, by the way. When I was a little child, I went to a Methodist church, Sunnyside Methodist Church in Portland, Oregon, and they never once prayed with me the prayer of salvation. Why? Because I was a child and I didn't understand. I'm sorry. I forgive you. I loved you. I loved going there. The memory of going there and seeing the Christmas, being part of the Christmas show, and Easter Sunday, and wearing my little black patent leather shoes and the beautiful little dress, you know, the little Easter dress my mother would make me. And but you know, then later on I started growing up, and I started, you know, I didn't have Jesus in my life. Why? Because you think the little children can't understand getting Jesus in their life? It's easier to get a child into heaven when they're a child, instead of waiting till they're like me, 26, 27 years old, who have gone through the gamut of sins, blah, 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 the fleshly sins, smoking and drinking and blah, 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 including having an abortion, okay? But, and I'm trying to stay calm here. Okay, but I only got a few minutes more because I want to make this video short. But please, if you're in the children's ministry, that you pray with those children every single Sunday that they come to Jesus. Just say the prayer. Just explain it to them quickly and simply, and have them pray the prayer of salvation, okay? And stop thinking of them as children that don't know nothing, or they're just too stupid or young to understand what you're saying about Jesus Christ. Okay, please, I beg you. Because I know in my heart, if I would have had Jesus in my life from a child, and God says in the Bible, I think it's in the book of Acts, possibly, that you knew him from a child. I knew him when I was sitting in that cherry tree reading a book and seeing the robins on the ground eating, and me just enjoying God's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful earth. You know, I remember knowing him, but I didn't know him. I didn't ask him into my life, okay? So you, if you are older, if you're a child, or if you're an adult, Jesus died for our sins. He died for your sins. We ask him to come into our life in Jesus' name. Come into my life, Jesus. Forgive me for all my sins, all the wrong that I did, all the wrong that I might do in the future. And we do. Okay, let's be real. We do. Okay? No matter how long we've known the Lord, we sin every day, okay? And maybe we don't outright sin every day, but there are thoughts that go through our brains. I'm not the only one. Please don't tell me I'm the only one. And I'm not talking about lust and sexual sins of thoughts and blah, blah, blah. No, just regular, just real life situations. And then I got to go, oh, forgive me, Lord. I confess, man. Forgive me, not man, but he's God. But you know what I'm saying? He just wants us to agree with him that we're just, you know, he's God and we're not. And we need him and we call on his grace. So let me finish here and then I'll quit this video. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. So, and then he said, and those were the words of Jesus, then in the black that was red, he says, and he took them up in his arms, he put his hands upon them and blessed them. And Lord, oh, and then it goes into, that's Mark 10, and I'm going to end right there, but it goes on to be real good in verse 17. Continue on, because this goes over to 52 verses. And so Lord, bless the people. Bless the people and let them know I love them. I'm not being hard on them. I'm just, you're using me to wake the church up at times. You're using me to wake people up. And I, you know, I come to you, Lord, you know, just come to you right now and ask you, God, to forgive us all for our sins and come into our lives and fill us with your Holy Spirit, and thank you for your eternal life, the promise of eternal life, God. Help us make great choices in the earth. Help us make great choices in life. Help us to have a good attitude and quickly forgive. Quickly forgive, Lord, and forgive us quickly. And Lord, help us have a kindness and love and truth. Help us to speak truth and kindness. Help us to react with kindness, not anger and uppity like I'm better than thouest. Father, all the way up until we go be with you, I don't like to use age here, but as we grow in years, Lord, don't let us have the excuse that just because we've been there, done that, and worked so hard our entire life, and we have this and you don't, and you know what I'm saying, or we have this and by golly, you know, you will respect me, blah blah blah, and by golly, I've worked so hard in my life, and how dare you, and you know what I mean, those attitudes, and how we can think that we can just treat people with disdain and disgust and anger. Believe me, I'm sure I've reacted in anger. So Lord, help us all and help us have a great day with fun, whatever that is. It could be as simple as watching a movie or TV or playing, if you're a child, playing your games, you know, playing with your toys and playing with your friends and getting along and just being buddies, you know, a clean, good life. And for all those people out there that are struggling, that don't have that, that don't understand what I'm talking about, all the people, gangs, Father, that grew up in gangs, in areas where they got pulled in, deliver, Lord, and protect from all the stuff that comes along with all the heartache in life, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless. Have a great day, everybody. God bless.